We're Revocation.
And you're watching
BareBonesMusic.com!
Yeah.
ELG, BareBonesMusic.com. I'm here with the guys in Revocation. Guys?
Hello.
Thanks for taking the time. Appreciate it. Do the handshakes down the line here. Got your good beverage here. Now, being that we're in Kentucky, you do know this is the bourbon capital.
Yeah.
So are you indulging in the bourbon while you're here, maybe? Or get some before you head out on the road?
Hopefully later tonight, yeah.
Later tonight, yeah. After the set.
We've only been in Kentucky for about 25 minutes, so
okay. Well, we're not
fully shit-faced yet, but give us...
If you need any good recommendations for bourbon, I'd be happy to give them to you.
We passed the distillery thing, I think. Is that on, like, the route or, like, the bourbon trail or something like that?
Yeah. There's a whole thing down here in Louisville. And this area here, lovely section over here, you got nice strip clubs, you get some... It's quite the venue here, but we love Expo 5. You guys are right now on tour with Children of Bodom. On their 15th anniversary tour. Tell me what that's like.
It's excellent. The shows have been huge. All the bands are great, with Elevati from Switzerland, Bodom, Threat Signal from Canada, and we're just having an amazing time.
Now, you only have about 8 more dates in this tour coming down to the end of it. You're kind of sad to see it wind down right now?
Yeah, it's always sad when tours end. You know, like, you get to, like, bro down with everybody, and, like, it's kind of like a weird sort of summer camp for, heavy metal summer camp for, like, 5 weeks. Everyone's, you know, crammed in the same... you know, venues and just hanging out. So it's always sad to end the tour, but it's cool, like, later on, like, you know, if you do, like, a, you know, random show here, like, another tour, you, like, get to see, like, the same faces again. Like, that's always kind of a nice, reminder, like, you know, people you've, like, hung out with on tour before and stuff like that.
I'm just looking forward to not having to live in a van with these shitheads anymore and smell their asses 24/7, so I'm thrilled.
Oh, okay, well, that...
Yeah, the feeling's not mutual, Phil.
Well, let's talk about your album, Chaos of Forms. It's been out since August of 2011, so a little over 6 months now. And one thing I noticed going into the end of 2011, every website does this, you know, us, we didn't really get a whole lot done, but your guys' album has been on almost everyone's top 10 or top 20 best metal albums of 2011. Being that this is your third studio album, how does that, I mean, I know it's just a bunch of us guys with our opinions, but how does it feel, does it make you feel good? Do you feel like you've accomplished something with this record here?
Well, you want to feel like you're doing something right, you know, because
sure.
then you can keep on going, but you try not to get too invested into the criticism, only try to make it better all the time. So if people are saying a lot of good things, sometimes it's better not to pay too much attention to it, because it's not what you need to hear if you really want to move forward.
Right.
But it's great. It's nice.
I really love the album. And talking about going from Chaos of Forms from your last records, you have a little bit more diversity on this record. It seems like you still have your thrash death metal edge to it, but you got wah pedals and some solos. You got some nice, just kind of balls out rock. Not breakdowns, because not really a breakdown band, but some grooves going on. Is that your new progression going in with this record and moving forward, trying to just get more of those elements in there?
Yeah, I think we, you know, try to be diverse in our music. You know, at the end of the day, we wanted to sound like Revocation and to be, you know, heavy metal, but, you know, throwing in little, you know, sprinkles of, like, rock and roll or some other different types of, you know, genres. Like, you know, The Watchers, for instance, had, like, a horn section and a Hammond organ solo on it. Dissolution Ritual had kind of more of, like, a Latin kind of atheist-inspired solo section. We like to experiment with these different things. I think it's just kind of a symptom of, like, you know, we all listen to different types of music. We all listen to heavy metal, obviously, but, you know, I listen to jazz, and, like, a lot of different guys listen to a whole bunch of different genres. So we try to, you know, incorporate, you know, different parts of those into our music, as long as it still has that kind of, you know, evil or, you know, kind of some, you know, it creates a different kind of atmosphere for the music, but still remaining, like, heavy metal.
Give me some bands that you listen to that you people might normally not think you would, but might surprise some people.
Radiohead. I love Radiohead. Huge fan. I think they're incredible. Dan, you got one?
Beatles, Jimi Hendrix, Zeppelin, classic rock shit.
Stuff too.
Dan, believe it or not, listens to a lot of black metal. And you wouldn't ever think that.
You never know. But I love extreme metal with blast beats. And, believe it or not.
I think Boys to Men, the first CD I ever bought was Boys to Men 2 when I was like 8, and so I will still fucking get really, really, really fruity when I put that CD on.
He'll get wasted in the van, just crank that. You know when Phil's drunk and when the Boys to Men comes on, you know, he'll serenade whoever.
Yeah. Everybody watch me sing.
We listen to a lot of Biggie in the van.
Yeah, we like hip-hop.
Wu-Tang,
yeah.
Stuff like that.
Now you're gonna start with all the different, one of the trends in at least some metal today is re-releases and remixes. What do you think about the whole remix and people doing like dubstep on metal records?
Personally,
do
you think it's really cool?
Do you think it's cool?
I think it's awesome. Okay. I think that people should have no boundaries when it comes to music. Combine, collaborate, mix, match. It's interesting. Why be locked in a box? That's my opinion. I'm not sure if it reflects the opinion of everybody else, but that's my opinion.
To me, like, it's not like my taste in music, but like what Anthony said, like, you know, it's cool to, like, you know, experiment with different things. You know, even if it's something that at the end of the day, like, I'm not gonna listen to, like, you know, I think it's cool for people to have an open mind when, you know, experimenting with different stuff, and like, you know, you never know like what you could, you know, come out with, you know. And I mean, I'm sure like a lot of metalheads probably think like, you know, you know, we're not, you know, full on, you know, heavy metal purists either. At the same time, we experiment with some different things as well. So it's not going to be with like dubstep, but, you know, with other types of genres. So, you know, it's collaborating and, you know, trying different things, you know, try something new.
Yeah.
Try things with ice.
I think I'm not opposed to any sort of way to experiment and push boundaries of music at all. I just, a lot of the times, don't really like how people do it. But certain bands like, Abu Gore and Dodd Heinsgard, bands that Dan turned me on to, they do it in a more unique way than I think a lot of people are used to. And then in those cases, it's fucking awesome. So,
go on, Phil.
No, I don't know. That's it.
A few years ago, I don't know if you know the band Animosity. We're huge fans of them. They had their album Animal remixed by Drum Corps, this artist, and I think that's really awesome.
From this tour and from the new record, I know that now that you've had it under your belt, like I said, for about 6 months now, what has been like some the songs from just that particular album that people are really responding to? Is there one particular that people just that kids know now and they really want to do? And is there a particular song from that record that you guys looking on the set list and say, this song's coming up, this is one I'm gonna go ape shit on or something?
I think one that people kind of gravitate towards is No Funeral, just because we put on a music video for it. So a lot of people, The Watchers is one people like a lot. It's kind of more experimental. That's one song with the horn section. It's all death metaled out. I don't know. The cool thing about this record is that every song individually I have heard as someone's favorite. Yeah. And so that's really cool feedback to get when it's, you know, you feel like you didn't put out an album with any filler tracks, that every single song on that record is somebody's favorite song. So that's really cool.
I like the fast ones.
Fast ones? And which one in particular?
I guess Cradle Robber. Kind of miss playing that. Yeah, it's got the dueling solo, you know. Hopefully we'll do more of that in the future.
Yeah, and how does that help you guys out now on stage, having, you know, being able to do dual solos and
people like the Bill and Ted moments, you know? It's like, it's fun. Me and Dave are tapping, we look at the crowd, and they're like, yeah, it's great. You gotta do more of that.
Well, now that this tour is about to wrap up and going into the summer, what are you guys' plans? Can you tell me anything that you got coming up in the summer? Because I know this is the time, spring and summer is when we start to get heavy into some serious touring. So, and you guys got, you know, like I say, you've got that time underneath your belt with this record. So what are you gearing up for?
Stuff. Stuff is coming.
We can't announce anything yet, but there's some stuff happening for sure.
It's a very, very busy summer for us, for sure. But we can't say anything specific.
Here in the States?
We should be state heavy during the summertime, and then hopefully get some things cooking up over in Europe and beyond. So, stay tuned.
Awesome. Well, guys in Revocation, remember, just come to me afterwards. I'll give you some good bourbon tips.
Yes.
Gotta give you ones that are, you know, fairly inexpensive but still very good in the world. Well, no, I give you ones medium price. It's worth your while. So check them out now. They're like 8 more dates on this tour, but be sure to pick up their album. I know everybody's like, I don't buy albums anymore, but you should buy their album. Chaos Forms is a great record. Come to shows, buy some t-shirts. I know these guys have to live in a van and sweat their ass off, and he doesn't want to find any stinking ass anymore. So help them out. give them some cash, and be sure to check them out in the summer. I don't know where they'll be, but it'll be announced pretty soon. So check them out, Revocation guys. Thanks for taking the time. Appreciate it. Have an awesome show tonight. Looking forward to it.
Thanks, Russell.
Love it, man. All right. He's-